Give me reasons to doubt, try to keep me down, but I'll put the flame out, you can't get to me. I know not everyone's gonna agree with this video. I know I'm gonna get dislikes. I know that when I say the sky is blue, there will always be people who disagree. I say the grass is green, people will disagree. No matter what, you're gonna run into that in life. That's what makes this world so great, is that you have your own opinions. You have your own beliefs. You could live in the same state as someone, same street as someone even, and still view the world differently. Everyone views the world differently, no matter who you are, age, gender, where you live, how much money is in your bank account, we all view the world differently. And I've said this before and I'll say it again. Words are just words, mean absolutely nothing. What you write on a poster in a protest means nothing, means absolutely nothing. When I write quotes and post them on social media, they mean nothing. Those words only have value until you actually put them into action and make them reality. When you write something about women's rights, those are just words. Those are your feelings written down on a piece of paper, posted on Facebook. Just words mean nothing. Until you actually put those words into action, make them reality, then they have meaning, then they have value. Then you can do something with it. With everything that's going on, we are divided. This nation is divided right and left. Wrong and right, right and wrong. Whatever side you're on, you think the other side is wrong, no matter what. You could agree on something, but still disagree on that. That's just the way life is. But it's how you go about voicing your opinions and respecting someone else's opinions. So yes, this is geared toward the election. This is geared towards Trump being our president and the women's march the other day. This also goes just in life in general. Do not let one person, event, or thing change the way you wake up every morning or go to bed at night and all the hours in between that. Do exactly what you did 2 months ago, a year ago. Don't let one person, thing, or event change that. You are you. You are unique. You believe one way or the other, and you view the world the way that you view the world. Your neighbor might disagree, but that's okay. Respect that. If you want to change the world, you want to change the next 4 years, 8 years, 10 years, start right now. But it's how you do it. And I'm not going to say one side is right and one side is wrong. This is just my opinion. This is my viewpoint. This is our reality. Trump is our president. People love it. People hate it. That's our reality. But it's how you go about that reality that you can either enjoy the next 4 years or hate the next 4 years. So you have the Women's March. Millions of women all across the U.S. on planes, trains, driving 6+ hours to different cities just to march. Spending hours making signs, hats, all of this kind of stuff to march for hours about something that they believe so strongly and so passionately about. And I think that is great. If you love something so much, to spend that time, money, and effort to get your voice heard, I think that is great. You take what you believe in and you take it as far as you want. But it's how you do it. It's how you go about that. So we had the Women's March. Did anything change the day after? For women, did any rights change the day after? Was there an instant change because of those protests, because of that march? I don't think so. Yes, the voices were heard, but did it actually do something? And this is what I'm gonna say, people can disagree, that is fine. I put this on social media and I'm open to all opinions. Could those women in the protest, in the march, have spent that money on the plane ticket, the hotels, the food, travel, all that stuff, towards something else? Could they sold the pink hats and taken all that money to a foundation for other women? Could they have taken the money for the hotel and give it to a single mother raising 5 kids who's got 3 jobs and help support them? That's instant change. That's taking action for your beliefs. I'm not saying that the march is wrong or it shouldn't have happened. I'm saying that's great. You got your voices heard, but now what are you gonna do? You marched and say, okay, put the sign that you made in the closet, hang up the hat, and go about your life hating it because of this new man that is in charge? No. Think about what you can do right now. Every morning when I wake up, I have the ability to post a motivational quote on Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook. I have that ability. I have that ability to start off my morning on a positive note, and everyone else who follows me on a positive note.
I chose to do that. Just because someone different is in charge, I'm not gonna stop that. I'm not gonna make it negative quotes. Change what you can. Control what you can and deal with what you cannot. It's gonna be hard. You're gonna run into people who disagree with you. You say the sky is blue, they're gonna say you're wrong. That's life. That's life. Stick to your gut, stick to your opinion, stick to your passion, stick to the way you view the world, but it's about how you go about it. In a positive way, respect someone else for their views. Because they see this way and you see this way. That's fine. That's what makes us so great. But now, whether you know you want more rights for women or you want more rights in your job, whatever it is, this doesn't have to be just about the election, whatever it is, start small. Start with what you can control. Save money and send it to a foundation. Start helping other families and other single mothers in your community. Or is it for jobs? Start your own company. Start bringing other people in, helping those around you. You see someone homeless on the street, help them out if you can. And don't just do it for their reaction. Don't bring your phone and show yourself handing groceries to a homeless man. Post it on Facebook and wait for people to recognize you for what you did. It shouldn't be about what other people think about you. It should be about how you personally feel and how you made the other person feel. So when you help out someone who's homeless or you help a single mother, it should be the reaction that they have and then how it makes you feel. Don't do it so you start trending on Facebook, whatever it is. There's more to life than what other people think about you. If you go through life worrying about what other people think about you, you are gonna have a tough, tough life. Don't wait for the world to program you. Start programming your world. You see where you wanna be in 4 years, 8 years, 10 years? Start right now. Start right now. Whether you're protesting, you're sending money somewhere, or you're simply holding the door open for someone. Do what is necessary for you. Stick to your gut, stick to your passion and your view of the world. But also at the same time, you must be open to others. The only way you're going to enjoy life. It's the only way you're gonna deal with the people who say, the sky is not blue. Whatever rant you post on Facebook, whatever comment you leave on someone else's viewpoint of the world, whatever you wrote on your poster for the Women's March, that's great. Congratulations, you were able to write something out. That's good, you spoke your mind. But now do something about it. Otherwise, it's just words. It's just a rant on Facebook, just so you get heard. But you do nothing about it. So don't expect the world to change if you don't actually do something. So whether you're in the Women's March or you're against the Women's March, do something about it now. You protested this thing, now try to change it. Whatever it is in life, you protest your boss at work, something simple as that. Now do something about those words. Take action and make it reality. If you want a better life for your daughter, for your niece, for your granddaughter, take an action. But it's about how you do it. About how you deal with those other people that say the sky is not blue. Words are just words on a paper, on your phone, on the computer, on a poster board, or on Facebook. Until you take action and turn those words into reality.